Hi, my name is Eric Normand, and these are my thoughts on functional programming. So I have kind of a weird topic I want to talk about today. It has to do with small talk and functional programming. So the more I read about small talk and its history and what early programs in small talk looked like, the more it strikes me as a very functional language. The abstractions, the little data structures that people created are defined in a very recursive way. So there's, in I think the paper, The Early History of Small Talk, there's a linked list that's created that has a little object that has a value and then a pointer to the rest of the list, and the method length is defined by adding one to the length of the rest of the list, and it adds all the methods are short like that. It's just some very simple concise code that defines this whole linked list in the whole interface of the linked list, including the implementation, is, you know, a note card worth of code. And a number of other things where Alan Kay has said, there is a number of other things that has made me think that when we talk about object-oriented programming, what we now call object-oriented programming has missed the point. That what Alan Kay tries to emphasize is the stuff that is much more like what I'm calling functional programming, which is kind of ironic. Alan Kay has said that there are only two object-oriented languages in the world, Smalltalk and Lisp, which Lisp is not traditionally thought of as an object-oriented programming language. So does that mean that our definition of object-oriented programming is just different from his, and he's the creator? I mean, obviously it is different, but is it that different that he would classify Lisp as object-oriented and almost no one else would? The fact that he has a lot of respect for Lisp as an idea, that he was inspired by Lisp to create Smalltalk. I think that object-oriented programming and functional programming have a lot more in common than we like to think about. And the modern practices of like organizing these big classes with lots of mutable state and you know, all the stuff that you would do in a Java program, I think that that is not really what I'm going to call it true object-oriented programming is all about. And creating these little abstractions that have neat little interfaces with nice recursive definitions, which is much more like functional programming, that is what the original definition of object-oriented programming is supposed to be. And so I'm going to go and say it. I'm going to say Smalltalk is a functional language. If Lisp can be object-oriented, then Smalltalk can be functional. And well, that's my short idea of the moment. I do think that the good practices in both of them converge, that you should be thinking about making your, like in functional programming, we think you need to have short functions. In object-oriented programming, you have small objects with short methods. So they all kind of converge onto the same principles. It's just good programming at the end of the day. Now, what's different is the terminology, the ideas, the practices, the approaches to problem solving. But at the end of the day, good code is good code. And if you're going to make a small recursive definition of something, that should work in both paradigms. All right. My name is Eric Normand. This has been a thought on functional programming, a weird one about small talk and functional programming and object-oriented programming. And thank you very much. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. If you go to Twitter, I'm Eric Normand. You can also email me, eric@lispcast.com. It's my email address. Love to hear from my listeners. Please let me know if you disagree, if you agree, anything. If you like it, if you don't like it, let me know. All right, see you then. Bye.